I was going to become the next great engineer. But what I found was that engineers were really boring. And I don't mean that personally for the engineers in the room, but it was in context. There were things going on in 1962, the civil rights movements, other kinds of things, and that was much more exciting. Because Robert L. Green, one of MLK's lieutenants, was an advisor to my fraternity at Michigan State University, I was fortunate as a young man to meet Martin Luther King. My meeting with Martin Luther King was life transformative. PRBA is probably one of the best examples of team science that we had. We didn't do this because of some conceptual reason that we invented. We didn't have any choice.
We also had a study that was non-comparative in the sense of focusing only on the African-American population. As it turns out, that was considered to be heretical. It was not only that this was unique and new, it was heretical. Why would you do this kind of study on Black Americans, and what were you going to learn from not having a comparative study? That was a major question. That we weren't just doing research to be doing research to lengthen our vitas, but instead, the notion was that we were to give voice to the real imperatives and needs of the African American community, which had been overlooked in the kind of social science research that had been done before. What we didn't know was that if we were really going to train community interviewers, which we were, and secondly, we were going to be interviewing based on a sample on the distribution of the Black population, that put us into locales which were very problematic. So we'd wind up with the third floor of the fifth building, and Cabrini Green came into the sample, and we were going to select three apartments within that particular area. So that meant we had to send people to knock on those particular doors. The door would open, and the person would then say, "I'm from the Institute for Social Research at the University."
I have an earlier writings termed my generation of Blacks the disappointment generation, because the hopes and aspirations, the confidence in the future of that era did not transform quickly into what were reasonable hopes of full citizenships. Change is coming. It may not be as rapid or broad as many of us would like. Now is the time to redouble our efforts to increase opportunities, equity, and inclusion in the academy. An overarching value for all of us must be in the continuing education and training of future generations. This is the fundamental engine of change and progress, and the vehicle by which our children secure a brighter future.